And I talked to them before about up here, the whole process of it. Like, I cut the piece of wood, I whittled, I got all the bark off. I was amazed. I was just dumbfounded when I did it. The second photo is my sister actually burning the wood, smoking it. So then one back a bit. So she's smoking it. And when you smoke it, it actually takes all, like inside wood, there's still moisture. So she's smoking it to get all the moisture out, and that actually makes the wood stronger. Then the next one, my sister is putting a design on there, and she's doing it with a tool that we got from Bunnings. Back in traditional days, they would have put things in the fire and it would have taken forever to make those designs on there. The next one, I'm holding on to an echidna quill. And back in traditional days, they used to use them to pierce holes in the kangaroo skin. I'm doing it with the possum skin there to put a hole in so that I can thread the rope through to attach it to it. So that's what they used to use, echidna quills, to put holes in their things, because kangaroo skins, possum skins, they're all sewn together to make cloaks. Traditionally, everyone had their own cloak. That was their cloak that they had for life, and they would last for life because they're very strong. It's strong fur. So I use a quill to put a hole in this possum skin, and then I could thread the stringy bark rope through. And then this is the fourth one, fifth picture. I'm putting the tying it all on, and then that's Ben and my yarning sticks. And it says our possum skins come from New Zealand, where they are considered a pest and are culled. Hope you enjoyed that, guys.
Yeah, we did. Investing man said, I'll double your wages, 18 quid a week you'll have in your hand. Vincent said, we're not talking about wages, we're sitting right here till we get our land.